Hi friends, let's solve problem number 8 on Fourier series. Find the Fourier series expansion for the periodic function fx if fx is given as there are two ranges given, minus pi to 0 and 0 to pi. Between minus pi to 0, this is constant, minus pi, and between 0 to pi, this is variable x. But what happens at 0? At 0 there are two values, so this function is discontinuous at 0. So we'll have to take the mean of the two values when we come to 0. Let's solve that when it comes. Let's write the standard Fourier equation first. A0 by 2 plus summation an cos nx bn sin nx 1 to infinity. Now A0 is, as we know, 1 by pi minus pi to pi fx dx. Okay, it can be 0 to 2 pi, minus pi to pi, anything which is variable constantly repeating, same time period should be repeated. So we'll break this period now, minus pi to 0 and 0 to 2 pi, because there are two functions. Input the value of fx in the respective functions, minus pi over here and x over here. Then solve the integration. This is a definite integral, solve it as it is given over here and you should get this answer, minus pi by 2. I recommend that you pause this video and then solve it personally and try to get this answer. Now an. An equals to 1 upon pi minus pi to pi fx cos nx dx. Standard Fourier equation. So input the values, minus pi to 0 first, 0 to pi then, because two functions. So input the respective values, minus pi over here, x over here. Minus pi will be constant, it will be taken out, and cos nx is sin nx upon n. And here uv. X is u and this is v. Always take u as that function which gets nullified or cancelled or zeroized, and which continues, take it as v. Solving this definite integral, you should get this answer, this. And then y minus 1 raised to n, because it's cos. Always remember, cos n pi is minus 1 raised to n, and cos 2 n pi is always plus 1. So when n is even, this will be plus 1 and this will always be 0. When n is odd, this will be minus 2 and the answer would be this one. Accordingly, we get a1, a3, a5, a7, etc. Now bn. Same logic, 1 upon pi minus pi to pi fx sin nx dx. So again break it, minus pi to 0, 0 to pi. Constant function, minus pi to 0. Variable function, 0 to pi. Again take the integrals. This will be a single, sin nx integral is cos nx upon n, and this will be uv. So solve this and input the values of 0 and pi wherever required, and minus pi and 0, and you should get this answer. Here there is no denominator n minus 1, so it is applicable for all n's. Otherwise in some problems it's n minus 1, so it's not applicable for n equals to 1. In this case it's not the case. Again the same logic, cos n pi means minus 1 raised to n, and then again we'll follow the b1, b2, b3, we'll find out those. Here all are existing because nothing is getting cancelled over here. Substitute the values of a0, an and bn, you get this function. Now this is our final answer as of now, but now we have to derive. This is a deduction required by us. And x equals to 0, it is minus pi, also it is 0. So when such function is discontinuous over here, we have to take the mean of that, minus pi plus 0 upon 2. This is shown over here. Why are we doing this? Because we are asked the value of at x equals to 0, hence we are doing this. So just input the value of at x equals to 0, you will get this. You have to input this in 5, this answer which we got earlier. This is fx and these are the remaining terms. So now the last deduction is required. This whole square bracket is this one, summation, and you take pi by 4 on this side, then subtract, then it becomes minus pi by 4, then take 2 upon pi on this side, it gets pi square by 8, and minus minus becomes plus. You can download the YogaGuru app from Play Store to get these videos, online tests, question banks with explanations directly on your mobiles. You can get the 500 plus question banks with explanations and simulations on your email.